Good morning, Tigers, and welcome back to the world's greatest elementary school. We hope you had a fantastic weekend and are ready for another amazing week of learning. Last week sure was fun, a fun week with the PTA Carnival. We hope you had a blast playing games, jumping on the bouncy houses, or having a good time with your friends and family. A huge shout out to our amazing PTA and all of the volunteers, high school, adult, staff.
Yeah, it was awesome.
It was amazing. Here's some pictures from this week's event.
It is time to recognize our May and June Students of the Month for showing the trait of being self-directed learners. Teachers and staff are going to be awarding certificates over the next few days, and then on Thursday morning at 9 a.m. we're going to be calling all of our May and June winners down to the courtyard with your certificates so we can take your picture, and we'll show those pictures next Monday on Tiger TV. And then those pictures will also be displayed on the Student of the Month display board in that display case heading down to the Commons.
All right, last Thursday, our amazing Tiger Chorus, under the direction of Mrs. Moore, put on their spring concert. We want to congratulate all of our Tiger Chorus members on an amazing concert and to recognize their dedication for coming to school each Tuesday morning during zero hour for Tiger Chorus rehearsals. We also want to thank Mrs. Moore for all she has done in leading the Tiger Chorus. Here are some pictures from last Thursday's concert.
Well done, Tiger Chorus. Now we have one more grade level concert left for the year, and it is happening this week on Thursday. All of our kindergarten classes will be presenting the Three Piggy Opera. We are looking forward to their performance this Thursday, June 8th at 6:30 p.m. in the Commons. Good luck, kindergartners.
And you might have some special guests.
Yes.
All right, Tigers. Mrs. McAllen's class has put up the last story for the year on our story walk on the nature trail. We are gonna have great weather this week. Hopefully you or our class can get out and get a chance to check out the new story called A Letter from Your Teacher on the Last Day of School.
Ooh, that's gonna be good. This Wednesday, our fourth grade classes are all gonna be going on a field trip to the Washington State History Museum in Tacoma. We hope all of our fourth graders have a great time, and we know that you are going to represent Shadow Lake well as you explore the museum.
All right, last week we had two of our double marathon Workout Wednesday award winners serve as principal for the day. Congratulations again to Anna, who was principal for the day last Tuesday, and to Jacob, who served as principal for the day on Thursday. Today, you're gonna get to see Oakland in the role of principal of the day. All right, Mr. Abbey, what's on this week's lunch menu?
Oh yeah, all right, here we go, Tigers. A little bit different on Fridays. Remember, here is this week's lunch menu. Today is French toast. Tuesday is chicken nuggets. Wednesday, sweet and sour chicken. Thursday, hamburger. And then Friday is gonna be cheesy pull-aparts. And then Tigers, this is the last week of the school year for lunch bunches and recess clubs. First, third, and fifth grade, your lunch bunch is today. Kindergarten, second, and fourth, your final lunch bunch will be on Wednesday. And then there'll be recess clubs for all grade levels on Tuesday and Thursday during your lunch recess times.
Oh, I love that there's more breakfast options for lunch. All right, Tigers, it's time to recognize more of our amazing Tigers who have been earning those Tiger Paw tickets and were selected in this week's drawing. Our kindergarten winners are Jr. in Mrs. Dance class, Marshall in Mrs. Hurley's class, Emma in Mrs. Belmano's class, and Maverick in Mrs. K's class.
All right, for our first grade winners, we have Sarah in Mrs. Roberts' room, Jonathan in Mrs. Hansen's class, Kyron in Mrs. Yassine's class, Zakar in Mrs. Riley's class. Welcome back to Mrs. Riley. And then we have Timothy in Mrs. Nelson's classroom.
Oh, nice job, first graders. Moving on to second grade, we have Sydney in Mrs. Kortenkamp's class, Avery in Mrs. Kemp's room, Mackenzie in Mrs. Shireman's room, and Florence in Mrs. Meek's class.
Way to go, second graders. All right, moving on to third grade. Dakota, congratulations. You were selected in Mrs. Boyle's room. Abigail, you're the winner in Mr. McMaster's class. Jude, you were selected in Mrs. McGowan's room. And then Beckett, you were the winner in Ms. Mazzatelli's room.
Nice job. On to fourth grade. We have Reagan in Mrs. Bradley's class, Ivan in Mrs. Moffitt's room, and Izzy in Mrs. Isley's class.
All right, here are our fifth grade winners. Dylan, you are the winner in Mr. K's room. Annabelle, you're the winner in Mrs. Lish's room. And then Morgan, you were selected in Mrs. McCutcheon's class.
All right, winners. When it is convenient for your teachers, they can send you to the office to pick up your prize from the Tiger Paw Treasure Chest. All right, Mr. Abbey, what's going on with story time this week?
All right. Before we get in there, don't forget, Tigers, that this is the last week for your books. You're going to be turning in all of those books, and then Mrs. Smith is reading a book called The Smart Cookie.
All right, Tigers, we hope you have a great week, and remember,
it's a great day to be a tiger.
Hey, Tigers, welcome back to story time. I'm super excited to read another story. So you guys know this author, right? He wrote The Bad Seed and The Good Egg and maybe The Couch Potato. Now I've got The Smart Cookie. So this is written by Jory John and Pete Oswald, The Smart Cookie. All right. Another book that I bought at our book fair. Awesome book fair. The Smart Cookie. There he is. Looks like he's studying so hard. It says, "Greetings. I'm a cookie. I live in a bakery on a street corner near a river. Come on in." Welcome to our little community. It's a warm and supportive place to spend some time. Pretty fantastic, eh? These days, life is sweet, but my journey wasn't always a cakewalk. When I was younger, I couldn't have imagined fitting in here. For a long time, I didn't feel comfortable speaking up or sharing my ideas. I didn't feel like a smart cookie. I wanted to be a cookie who knew all the answers, a cookie who felt confident in a group, a cookie who said, "Aha!" when solving a puzzle like this. Aha! Looking back, I had some trouble in my early days. I went to school in a gingerbread house. Our teacher, Miss Biscotti, was kind and patient. When I arrived each morning, she'd wave at me and smile. But I didn't get the best grades, and I never raised my hand because I couldn't think of the answers as fast as the others. And I was the last to finish most tests. It wasn't because I didn't care, and it wasn't because I didn't try. Sometimes I'd get distracted and mess up, even though I knew the material. Those were the most frustrating moments of all. Once I misspelled the word dough. That was rough. Another time I added when I meant to subtract. Occasionally we'd have a lesson where I had absolutely no idea what was happening. I just couldn't keep up. I imagined that my desk was a raft and that I was completely lost at sea, because that's what it felt like. At night, I slept in a cookie jar. I had about 6 dozen roommates. They're like, move, you move. No, you move. No, you move. No, you move. I'd stay awake and stare out the window and worry. And it went this way day after day after day. But then something happened that changed everything. It all started with a homework assignment. Miss Biscotti requested our attention one afternoon. Tonight, I would like you to create something completely original, she announced. It could be anything you want. Please bring it to class tomorrow. That was it. There were no further instructions. Miss Biscotti winked at me as I gathered my belongings. I felt like I had a million butterflies in my stomach. Create anything? Something original? Due tomorrow? Gulp. Oh boy. Looks a little nervous. When I got home, I immediately went to work. At first, I tried a cooking project. The results were half-baked. Next, I tried to hammer and nail something. It splintered immediately. Then I tried making a sculpture. It was a complete bust. I wonder if I was about to fail yet another assignment. I was stuck. I stared out the window and watched the rain hit the river. There was something mesmerizing about the water, how it moved in such a chaotic way, swirling around and around, yet ultimately figuring out exactly where it needed to go. Aha! I suddenly had an idea. I decided to write something original, a poem. I came up with a title based on how I'd been feeling, My Crummy Days. After that, the rest of it seemed to fall into place. I wrote and I wrote. I lost track of time. An hour went by in a flash. Aha, I said when I was finished. I couldn't sleep that night, but it wasn't because I was worried. It was because I was excited. I felt like I had really accomplished something. I felt smart. The following day, Miss Biscotti asked for volunteers to share what they'd created. One kid showed off his original frosting art. Another kid revealed her sprinkled distribution machine. It was neat seeing how everyone was good at such different things. Finally, Miss Biscotti turned to me. Would you like to share anything? She asked. Gulp. I gulped. I thought I'd probably crumble under the pressure. But I made my way to the front of the classroom. I noticed my hands were shaking. My mouth went dry. This poem is called My Crummy Days, I said, my voice cracking. And then I read it aloud. As I spoke, I noticed some kids nodding at certain lines. Other kids laughed at parts that were supposed to be funny. As I built toward the finale, I felt myself becoming more confident and animated. And in the end, everybody clapped and cheered. I promise you this, I'll never, ever forget it. Miss Biscotti was beaming. No one but you could have written that poem, she said. It was completely original. Aha! I had done it. I created something and shared it with the world. Well, my world at least. The rest of the day was a blur. By recess, I was already planning my next poem. I would call it My Sweet Morning. Aha! I thought when I came up with the title. Later that afternoon, Miss Biscotti handed me a note. It said that I should keep on writing no matter what. That meant so much to me. school was a bit different after that. I wasn't so scared to raise my hands or ask questions or share my work. Sure, some things still don't come as easily for me as they do for others, but now I know that you can be smart in many different ways. You don't have to have the answers to every question or suddenly be great at everything all at once. You just need a chance to try all kinds of things to find out who you are and what you like to do. As for me, I learned that I can write and I can think of great ideas, and I found plenty of other things I'm good at too. I no longer feel lost at sea. It's more like floating down a river. And the best part is, there's always more to learn. This is poetry night because we are all smart cookies. There it is. All right. The smart cookie. Oh my goodness. I love that story. Remember, we are all smart cookies. You might have strengths in different areas than your classmates, and that's okay. You don't have to have all the answers. You might not be a good test taker, but you do your best and you have your strengths. So enjoy that. I hope you guys enjoyed that story. Now, just a reminder, last week was the end of library. You will still come to the library for Future Ready with Mrs. Spencer, but we won't do any more library or library checkout. So with that being said, all library books are due this week and by Friday, June 9th. So dig out those library books, look under your bed, look in your closet, look in your desk. All right, Tigers, find those books and get them turned in. And remember, it's a great day to be a Tiger.